You are now listening to Green Talk by Green Care Solutions on KCAA NBC Radio. You can also listen on iHeartRadio. This is a cannabis-friendly and educational program. You must be 21 years of age to listen. My name is Mr. Hello, Conovation in your life, and I got two of my amazing co-hosts in the house tonight.
What's up, guys? It's Trippy Trees.
Hey, bless up, sesh up. It's Miko, the Cannabis Businessman, and we've got Green Care Solution, award-winning. What is it? Three, four? What is it?
That's five times award-winning. Hello. Award,
back to back to back.
Yes,
we've
sir.
We've got Brian in the house and Tia from Green Care Solutions. How you guys doing? What's up, Brian?
I'm doing great. Thank you, guys. It's an honor to be here.
Great. Tia, did you bring out that endless bong for us today?
Of course we brought it for you guys today.
Can't wait. Let's talk some green. Let's get into it, shall we?
All right, so I want to know a little about what this can of hookah is all about. I mean, this is really innovating. I've never seen this particular
first
kind of product.
The only one on the market.
Right? So tell me a little bit about how and what this product is about. Can I put it in my bong? Can I smoke it in my pipe? Can I put it in a blunt? What can I do? What do I got to do to use this?
Tia, tell us.
So what you need is you're going to need a hookah rig for it. Basically, you're going to think about you need a rig for your dabbing. You need a rig for all of that. You're going to need a hookah to use this. You can get one, a small one. You can get a big one. Just depends on what you're looking to smoke from it.
Now, it's based with tobacco or salvia. What is the difference with this hookah compared to the rest of the hookahs?
So what makes this this product so different from everything else is that it has zero tobacco in it. There's absolutely no tobacco at all in it.
Trippy.
Oh, that's nice.
Trippy, yeah. I think this might be some for you.
I know,
then,
that
right?
Made me smell.
Trippy was excited. No tobacco. That's great. How many milligrams do we have in this?
It's 1,000 milligrams per jar. Whoa. So it's pretty strong.
Ooh, wee. That's going to get
you. Can
you
do
slumped.
All that in one sitting, or how many, like?
If you want to put it all in one bowl, you could put it all in one bowl.
Now
but
we know what Trippy's throwing up. We tell her
no,
how many milligrams
asking,
she
like,
wants it all.
What's the common dose, you know, like how to use it?
So in your average bowl, you're going to get, out of one jar, you're going to get about four uses out of it for your average size bowl that you would use on a hookah.
Hey, Brian, I want to know, what is it that, how do you like, how is your dosage? What is the dosage that you prefer for yourself? I mean, I know I smoke a lot of marijuana. So I would like to know, maybe me and you are on the same, and you like that edibles.
Yes,
so
absolutely.
So that dosage needs to be high. So how much do you use, and what is your sense on this? I know that you're part of this great and amazing team, so I'd like to hear your input as well, please.
Absolutely. Well, first of all, we actually started out with only doing 500 milligrams, and it was good. It got people feeling pretty good, relaxed, but at the end, when we made it to 1,000, and that's what we stuck with, that was my dosage right there.
Dosage, okay.
So, you know, so that's when it did me right, and I fall asleep like a baby every single night I smoke it.
What was the first award you guys won? You guys are not three, not four, but
five times. Hello.
Five.
Come on, let's get
award.
That
What was
right.
the first award you guys won? Which was the event you guys went to?
The first award that we got was actually at the Tommy Chong's Blazers Cup back in December of last year. So they had it where you had to put no labels on it and everything, and it was new to everybody. Okay. So we actually got an award first time. We were surprised, but you know what? We were absolutely honored, and we knew we had something going on really, really strong.
That's awesome, Brian. So how'd you guys come up with it?
Well, our owner, Freddie, he's a very innovative guy. And one day, he goes to the hookah lounge every night, and we started the company, and he was wondering, what can we do to set ourselves apart from everybody else in the industry? He's looking, man, I'm smoking hookah right now. Let me look up cannabis or hookah, you know? So he looks up canna cigar. You know, that's already out there on the market.
Yeah, I've seen that out there before, absolutely.
So he said, yeah, let me look at cannabis hookah. Let me see if anything's out there. So he's looking through his phone, finds all these ways, tons of threads, all the failures pretty much.
Okay, he's doing his research,
so,
got it.
Yep, so he said, we need to make this work somehow. So he gets on the horn with our cultivator.
Okay.
Come meet me at the lounge tomorrow night, and we need to talk about something. So what happened was he said, this is what we got going on. Have you ever done anything hookah? I don't know anything about a hookah, our cultivator said, but let's give it a shot. And sure enough, 3-4 days later, came. We had the whole team at the lounge, tried out the 500 milligrams first.
Okay.
Everybody's tasted good, everything, but everyone's relaxed, but not to where, like I said, we wanted it to be at. A couple days later came, grounded up the troops again, Everybody, 1,000 milligrams, everybody was feeling lit. Let's just tell you that much.
That's right.
So the dream team came together. Tia, can you tell me what are the flavors you guys came up with once we decided to run with this can of hookah and be innovative? What were the flavors that came up? And what do you think for yourself? What's the best flavor for you?
So we have mango, strawberry, watermelon, pineapple, and blueberry mint. I love mint. It's one of my biggest obsessions. So the blueberry mint is definitely going to be one of my favorites.
Tasty.
I want to know what you think about, Brian. What's your favorite one?
And this, I always tell this to everybody. Every sesh we do, I literally discover this is my new flavor. So every time at a sesh, when I'm tasting and everything with the patients, I have a new favorite every single time. So right now, it's got to be pineapple, though.
Pineapple. Okay, so you know what I really wanted to get into, too, is with Trippy, because I know the whole thing about the hookah is that she throws up and all that. So now there's nothing that's added, no tobacco inside of it. And it's definitely something that I think that we can try with her that maybe will not upset her stomach. And again, to the listeners listening, again, this is an innovative product. So I appreciate
that. They're also
that.
Working on a CBD product, too, we need to be looking out for, right?
So see.
That's going to come out, actually, and that's what we're really excited about. That's the next to come from Green Care Solutions. We're going to have a CBD version of the can of hookah. This will be in all your hookah lounges,
Green
all your
Care
smoke
has
shops.
All of your Green Care Solutions. If you want to contact them, contact them on Instagram at Green Care Solutions 420. Their phone number for delivery and questions, 951-609-4071.
Again, that's Green Care Solutions 420 on Instagram, and that's 951-609-4071 for all of your needs. I have a question. What was your very first sesh, Green Care Solutions? Your very first sesh, where did you even start at? How did Green Care Solutions even become before the canna hookah began?
All right. Well, let's just say the first sesh we went to was in Moreno Valley called Steadicess, and a man that's called the canna businessman was there hosting the show that day.
Canna businessman. Hello. All
suited
right.
Suited and booted in Moreno Valley. Sesh, so everyone out there understands, Trippy will give you a little breakdown on her first sesh experience. A sesh is basically an environment kind of like a lounge, kind of like where you go and do your wholesale shopping with some entertainment. Trippy, mm-hmm. What was your first experience of the session? What was the session to you in definition?
So I guess mine was like the first ever was High Times Cannabis Cup, like back in the good old days when you could literally just have like pounds everywhere and like walk home with pounds.
Not the music festival in the petting zoo?
I mean, no, they didn't even have a petting zoo back then. Yeah, that's funny. They got to bring people in the crowd now. But yeah, no. So that was my first ever one. That was literally my first ever job. Literally was working at a booth. And then from there, I just grew out. And but that was the most fun one.
Kano, where did you originate in the sesh community?
I started in the depths of San Bernardino at the Elks Lodge. Somebody handed me a microphone and said, get to it, brother. Anyways, it started a long time ago in San Bernardino, and I started with you at the same spot, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
Yes, sir, correct. You're correct. I started back in San Bernardino at the Elks Lodge as well.
Yes, sir. He was booted and suited, and you know what? From day one, me and this man said to each other, we're going to do big things together.
Here we are. Kind of hello, as
hello,
you say.
Hello, as you would say, man. So we here.
We
back
came
to Green
up with
Care
some solutions.
Uh-huh.
They're available. They're always with us Wednesdays at the Elks Lodge in San Bernardino. If you come out Wednesday to the, we call it the Weeds Day Sesh.
Weeds Day Sesh. Backwood, yep, that's at the Wednesdays. Elks Lodge. Yep.
They're also available at the Elks Lodge with you, Connor. What day of the week are they?
On Saturday for San Burn Session. Speaking of that, we're going to be doing some really dope charity events with Green Care Solutions, and we're going to be having them Wednesday as well and Saturday. And what you're going to be able to do is get some cool raffle tickets. If you guys bring yourself a gift,
bring a
$10
gift,
unsealed gift, right?
Sealed gift. Make sure it's not violent, please.
Yes, please. This is for children and for people. Come on, man. Keep it right. Keep it light. All right, and also you can, if you don't have a gift, you can also donate anything over $10. You're going to get yourself a raffle ticket, if I'm not mistaken.
You're absolutely correct. And you're going to be giving back to a good cause. It's a toy drive, giving back to the kids. Shout out to Green Care Solutions for stepping up, showing that we're a charitable community and we're doing things outside of just cannabis to make sure that people are aware of us.
Absolutely, and the gifts are amazing. So you're going to want to check that out. The post will be up. If you go to Green Care Solutions 420 right now on their Instagram, all of the details are there right now. Again, not just for your cannabis needs, they're there for all of your needs.
Green Care Solutions love the kids.
Absolutely. Kind of businessman, let's get into something in Trippy, something about what an actual event or a cannabis event actually will entail. I mean, because we want to get in depth with you guys, listeners, so you guys get like an in-depth if you were here with us and you were walking through a sesh with us, what you go ahead, let's go with
it. It's Thursday. You know, you're full. You're sitting back. You're listening to Green Talk this Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. We want you to close your eyes and get the experience here. We're with the award-winning Green Care Solutions. They've done everything from the smaller sesh to the bigger events. So I'll start with the smaller sesh. A smaller sesh, you can expect anywhere from 10 to, say, 30 vendors on a regular day of the week. Setup is normally an hour before the sesh for the vendors to come in and get their products arranged. They have 6-foot tables and 10 by 10 spaces that we set up our arrangement. We set up kind of like in a cow herd, to be honest. It's kind of like for the flow for the people to go around the tables. So you'll do your shopping kind of familiar to you, closer to like a swap meet.
That part, I was gonna definitely explain like a swap meet, absolutely. Different in every aspect, different.
And you just have these different companies that are there. Some of these companies are brokers. Some of these companies are wholesalers. Some of these are actually the farmers that come down from all over. We have companies that come down from Sacramento, from Arizona. Some are extractors. The sesh is the bloodline of the market. It's where you're going to come. If you were looking downtown LA to find everything and you'd find the fashion market and so forth, that's exactly what the sesh would be. It'd be a smaller way for you to shop and find wholesale without minimums with multiple selections. From your perspective, Brian, you've been at the table. You've been behind the table at a sesh. You've been at the bigger events. We're going to get into the bigger events. What's your perception as a vendor? What do you see it as, and how's that experience for you when you're coming and having to set up and then deal with all these patients? How many patients do you see in a smaller sesh?
Smaller seshes, to be honest, I mean, we see a couple hundred easy daily, and that's within anywhere from a 4 to 6 hour time period. So you're serving a lot of patients coming to you, getting to know them on a personal note. We get to, you know, deliver to them. We do it all, you know. But as far as seshes goes, it's a day in and day out. It's a grind. So all the other vendors, shout out to every vendor that does this day in and day out, because without these people starting from the bottom and working their way up to the bigger events, we wouldn't have these big companies out there. These seshes is where it starts in my eyes.
And what's amazing about these seshes, ladies and gentlemen, is that they're in a lot of cities. You know, any city you can kind of find one of these. That it's, you know, we can go from San Bernardino all the way to L.A., Orange County. I mean,
everywhere now.
You can find a sesh anywhere. And that's what's so great is that these vendors have not only accessibility to start from somewhere like Green Care Solutions and make it to a 5-time award-winning to a small sesh all the way to the High Times and so many more. That gives also the patients the ability to go.
For example, High Times. So, Trippy, you've done High Times, the other events. What's the experience you can share with us in regards to the sesh or the events?
Well, High Times is a lot bigger, obviously. So when you walk in from a consumer standpoint, you walk in, you see hundreds of thousands of vendors.
And these are like in bigger locations too, right?
Yeah, so it'll be like a concert, similar to where you'll have, like where they used to have EDC Festival and Nas Center.
Okay.
You know, now I think they had to change it because of regulations, you know. So also regulations changed a lot of things.
Absolutely.
But back then, you know, it was like hundreds of thousands of vendors, like you said, booths all over, and you're just walking aisle to aisle, and you're finding vendors, different kind of products, all different brands, and it's really fun. Honestly, it's one of the most fun experiences I've ever had, really.
That high
and
energy.
Then, yeah, and you're just getting high. There's so many samples of everything, so you get to go from booth to booth to like just sample. So you're dabbing one, you're like trying a joint.
It's like Costco, like Chuck E. Cheese, and Disneyland.
Yes,
for
it
adults.
Is.
It's Costco
it is,
for
basically.
Adults, literally. I like that.
I have a question. Let's go with Tia. What would you prefer? You've been to a lot of events, and again, you guys have won multiple awards.
Five
award-winning. Again, Green Care Solutions on Instagram, Green Care Solutions 420, and you can also get in contact with them at 951-609-4071. My question to you, Tia, what do you like more, the smaller sessions or the big, big, big events?
I definitely like the smaller sessions a lot more. Just because I feel like you get to really know your patients, the bigger events are much more fast-paced. And the smaller events, I mean, they're fast-paced, but it's more intimate with your patients. I love seeing the same faces. You start building relationships with your patients. And I personally, I love, like, having connections with people. So definitely the smaller events are
my
favorite.
That's an excellent point, Tia. I think one of the main things, kind of Trippy, we can all agree on is that the sesh is more of a communion. It's kind of a place where you're getting to know each other. You are networking. Sales is the bloodline of the business while you're there. But like Trippy said, you get to know the people. We have nicknames. There's, I call them cannabis in the community. It's the people that we all know.
Absolutely.
And love. And I agree. The sesh would probably be more of the Tupperware party. compared to going to the Costco event, right? Where it's the well, Dabathon, the Champs, the Blazers, all the places you guys won all your awards. I think that would be the mainstay for what we could say is a difference. Smaller, more intimate. Great word there, Tia.
So here's what we can kind of try to get you guys as listeners to understand. So the bigger seshes, you're going to get essentially
more options.
More options.
More energy, mm-hmm. more people.
A smaller sesh, you're going to get more intimate. And now that you know what it is, we have big events, small events that go from city to city, state to state. What can we find there? You know, we can find wax, we can find canna hookah, we can find weed. But what kind of different strains? Is there different types of wax? Is there different types of weed? Is there what kind of things are we going to find? Can we find some drinkables, some edibles? I mean, Green Care, can you guys help me out? What is it that you guys all offer on your table other than the award-winning
can of hookah?
Absolutely.
Well, I'm glad you asked, because the biggest difference between our table compared to all the other seshes is everything we have are all licensed name brand products. So stuff that you can get at dispensaries, you can get it at a wholesale price.
Ooh-wee, that's the part that every patient looks for. Well, I know that we do.
Yeah, I'm a man that loves my money, and I love the sounds of wholesale with no minimums.
Yeah, I
definitely need to get with Green Care Solutions. Trippy, what do you find at the seshes normally? What is it you're finding? What are you looking and seeking out?
So I like getting flower from there. Obviously, wax too. I guess just any kind of product, really. You can get anything you want.
Literally.
I used to stock up on edibles too and everything, so it's just a lot easier just going to a sesh, getting what you need, and then not having to go to a dispensary and pay tax and all
that. Tia, you guys got any edibles that you guys are enjoying over there at Green Care Solutions? What do we got on the table that we're enjoying right now?
Definitely, I'm going to have to say the Moonrock edibles, just because Moonrock is, you can't go wrong with Moonrock, so those are pretty amazing.
Well, everybody in my company does me as Edible King, because that's pretty much what I mess with. But like Tia said, Moonrock makes great cereal bars. They work for me every time. We have infused lemonades. Everything we have, it literally is going to – I feel confident in telling patients about it, because I have taken everything on my table personally.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. And I think that everybody should, you know, try their products so they know the ins and outs of their products, so they can explain to each patient and or vendor or any consumer the effects. I mean, it's very important that you guys educate your patients so that they don't overdo it. For example, Trippy, I have a question for you. You know, there's people don't understand. There's a hybrid. I don't. Yeah, what's a hybrid? What's a sativa? What's an indica? What is a edible? What consumes of a lemonade that has some THC inside of it? You know, what are the things that we can find there? I mean, there's so many things that these listeners can't see, but they can actually hear, and we can explain to them in some way.
Tangible.
There
we're talking this green. This is Green Talk. So this is what we're here for. So we'll start with the sativa, right? Everyone likes a good sativa. The saying is awake and bake. Kano, not so much.
No.
Yeah,
me
Kano's,
neither.
Well, that's a perfect example. Two wonderful hosts it's that we deal with are very high energy. So I think a lot of people with high energy, with most of the side effects with sativa, it's going to give you a euphoric. It's going to give you that energy and that drive. It's going to give you that focus. So for people like us that are already high energy, I think that might not be what fits you. Now, sativas are normally enjoyed in the daytime because of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
For the energy.
Yeah.
I agree, the majority of us like to enjoy sativas in the daytime.
Absolutely.
Indica's primarily in the nighttime, kind of to set it in the body to relax you. A hybrid, which I'm really enjoying at this point in life, would be a mixture of the two.
Yeah,
finding
it's a mixture.
The fine blends. I know for a fact, Brian, that you guys have what is one of the most successful hybrids on the market right now, and that's the Purple Punch. It is, right?
Yes, it is. That has been the number one seller for us for the last 6 months.
It's beautiful, by the way.
Oh man,
kind of unfair they leave it open on the bag there, and everybody has to pass it.
It's very unfair.
Do by any chance anyone know the, when we say hybrid, so you guys understand, a hybrid would be the mixture of the two. So they would take a sativa and an indica and mix it. Does anyone by chance know what's inside the fruit punch, Brian?
Oh, the Purple Punch? Yes. Actually mixed with Larry OG and Granddaddy Perp. So if you guys actually see the purple color tone from it, it stems from the roots of the Granddaddy Perp. But then also, too, the Larry OG gives us that indica effect that you can do it for nighttime.
So, Tia, you tell me. You've enjoyed the Purple Punch, I'm sure. What do you enjoy about the difference in the hybrid of the Purple Punch? I said sativa, and everybody gave me the look. So tell me what we're going to get out of the Purple Punch.
So, actually, it's funny that you asked me, because Purple Punch is one of my favorite strains right now. It literally knocks you out. it says it all in the name. The purple punch definitely knocks you out, and that's my favorite part about it.
I have a question. Now, I'm going to go to Trippy on this, and for everybody, as a matter of fact, but I want to Trippy, please chime in. Weed does heal in many ways. Now, does each strain kind of heal in a different way? Like, for an example, would an indica be used, for example, my bad back, the sciatic that I have, migraines? And, for example, hypothetically, would my sativa be used because I have no energy? I mean, that's what I'm trying to, you know, what would the listeners be wanting to use these particular strains for and how?
Yeah, I feel like weed isn't just like weed, you know? I feel like people just think like, oh, I'm just going to go get high real quick. Let me just get something. But it's totally different depending on what you get. And there's something called like an entourage effect. So like if you're getting the full spectrum of like CBD, THC, like CBN, like all of that in there, that's in the flower plant itself. And then it's like different flowers. So with sativa, it's going to affect you differently. So it's more mentally, but it's also going to help with energy. So if you're feeling down or depressed or something, it's going to help you out. Plant. Yeah. Okay. Indica, like you said, the back. Or anything, just relaxing, anxiety, anything like that. And then
surprisingly, CBD, you're right, Trippy. People really don't realize. They think it's weed. It just gets you high. It's psychoactive. They think it's like, you know, we're all staring at the sky and watching clouds. But in actuality, there's a lot of veterans that suffer from things like PTSD, or even a lot of us in America's life today with what we're dealing with daily. It will calm you and relax you so that loud noises or something that would distract you or cause you to be in shock, you'd be at a more relaxed level. I know that there are things like sciatic nerves that people take indicas like
absolutely
for to relax themselves at night. It can increase appetite. There's a lot of people with nausea,
anxiety, depression.
It really is the full spectrum
with the plant, especially if you go into more detail and talk about like concentrates like RSO. They also call it Jamaican hash oil. There's a bunch of different names for it. Interestingly enough, there's been proof that the RSO oil, when applied, can remove the cancer cells. And
yes, they have proof of proven this. Fact, scientific
fact. There's been people that have been persecuted. Some had to stay in Amsterdam for years and not even come back home because they were giving away the medicine. Preface this on giving away. They were actually healing people.
Healing people.
People were leaving the country to come here to engage in the medicine. It really is medicine for a lot of people. So I'm glad you brought that up, Kano. So yeah, Tia, you deal with a lot of patients at the sesh. So that people get a good idea, they're here at Thanksgiving listening. We want to explain to them the variety of different people that come and what it is they're coming for. It's just not a party. Me and Trippy ain't just smoking away and high-fiving with Kano. Tell them a little bit about the patients that come in and what they're coming in for.
I definitely have a lot of patients who come in and will use our CBD products in order for anxiety. I have patients who use it for depression. I also have patients who will come in and purchase our infused drinks or even our flower for things such as fibromyalgia. You know, it's not just, most of the patients that I see are using it for a medical reason, not for recreational.
Yeah, surprisingly, even we found recently that children, there's stuff that they're giving to children to make sure to remove seizures, to stop seizures, a variety of different things. Kind of, I know you deal with patients every day as well.
I mean, as on a host perspective, I mean, even people think that, oh, I just smoke and smoke. I use it for, I have ADHD. I have a lot of things and issues that I have that go on in my life, and that's what I use it for. And, you know, the amazing thing about cannabis and these seshes and these things are that it brings people together. I mean, I see people that are way older than me, way younger than me, different colors, different races, different creeds. I mean, it's a beautiful thing. You can be any age, shape, or form and come into a sesh, and I promise you, you will be greeted with open arms, a joint, or some kind of amazing gift and a smile, especially if you've got the kind of businessman, Trippy or myself in the house. You'll be guaranteed to be well taken care of. And, you know, again, what it boils down to is this is a beautiful medicine that brings people together. And it's not just everybody sitting around singing Kumbaya, getting stoned out of their brains. And if you could give Green Care Solutions a call at 951-609-4071 or at Green Care Solutions 420, they'll be definitely able to help you with all of your needs and, you know, describe all of their amazing products for you. Trippy, I want to get into some more about the products again, pertaining to the indica. I like to use the indica. What is your particular favorite?
Everybody
strain?
Went crazy when I said
I like
sativa.
Indica.
I don't do the indica.
No, you know,
sativas.
It's funny, actually. I've done a poll one time on my Instagram story, you know, and I got a lot of responses, and it was 50-50. It was like 48-52. So it was very even split. We were all surprised by that. Yeah, so I guess most people, it's like a very even split. But I like indica personally. I like the heavy.
What is it, the indica, that what does it do for you, Tribby?
So I like, especially for nighttime, but I just like to relax. I just have a lot going on a daily basis and just a lot of, not even anxiety, but it's just more just so much going on that I just like to take a minute, relax, and use it throughout the day. And then at nighttime, definitely just use it to go to sleep.
What about you, Miko? You said the sativa, so I'm assuming is that your preference throughout the day, sir?
I am just a man of variety, and I like to enjoy a variety of different things. No, okay. I'm trying to get out of the norm and try to find out what everyone's enjoying with different things. So the hybrids really are what have led me to try sativas. There's a variety of different sativas. The only sativas I really run from, and I maybe we'll see if we get the same response from everyone, is the harsh. I don't like the spicy harsh. I think that's the main thing.
Like the cookies, like the deep Girl Scout cookies is a sativa. Now, if you go with that one, the Girl Scout cookies being a sativa, now, it's very odd that I say this because I don't like sativa because if for some weird reason, again, for myself as a patient, I get really stuck in my head. But that would be my only and only sativa that I would actually smoke would be a cookie. Girl Scout cookie. What about you guys, Green Care? What do you guys use and what do you guys personally use? I know you guys got that award-winning hybrid over there. Five-time award-winning. I know that. Golly, that's just crazy. Green Care Solutions for the win always, all day, day. Hello.
Well, personally, the infused edibles has to be indica-based because it helps me go to sleep at night, relaxes me, and not only that, I used to actually be a college athlete, and having really, really bad knees, the infused lemonades have actually really helped the joints in my knees, and I have not had to see my orthopedic in over a year now.
Wow. See, I'm with them on that. I do like to use those infused drinks. I use those every night to help out with my back as well. And with all of you guys inside of you, all know that I am a recovering alcoholic. That stuff right there helped out with that as well. Yeah. So I'm telling you, medicine, cannabis works, ladies and gentlemen. It's not just everybody singing Kumbaya. I'm telling you guys, get that Green Care Solutions in your life.
It's interesting, man. Different strands do different things to you. And surprisingly enough, if we're going to educate, we got to talk this green on green talk. There's people out there, like, for instance, Wiz Khalifa. Wiz Khalifa uses the side effects completely different from the ones we just explained. If we give him a sativa, he falls asleep. For us, we're up and euphoric and energetic.
Oh, wow. I've never heard of that.
Yeah. There's a real key science, I think, that we all realize to the plant now. There's a lot of new products out now that you look at on the market, and it'll say specific for sleep, for euphoria. So they've been able to extract exactly what it is for each of us. I'm just happy that with cannabis, there's not the side effects of most of the other drugs. Even Advil, common pill that's put across the counter. People aren't aware of what that does to your lining and your stomach, Motrin, things of that nature. So it's just happy to have a product out now that's been out forever that the government's stopped the hard stance on so we can get this information out. Thank God for Green Care Solutions and this Green Talk show. You need to get a hold of them and find out more about the solutions that they've come up with our Green Care. It's 951-609-4071. On Instagram, that's Green Care Solutions 420. What different strands are out there right now other than the Purple Punch? And what does it do for anyone? What are we all loving and enjoying right now? What's it doing for you? What's an exotic flower to Trippy?
Ooh, exotic. I mean, I guess I like dosidos, but it sucks. It's not exotic anymore. It depends who you get it from is what I think of as exotic. You know,
it's kind
of
like dogs breeding now, right? Like, do you have the papers on this? Is this an official dosido?
Yeah, that's true.
It is true. It is true because everybody flips it and does different ways. There's different growers. And like, example, I'm going to go back to this. Purple Punch is its own brand. You're not going to be able to find that Purple Punch somewhere else other than Green Care Solutions per se. Now, I'm going to go back to one of my favorites, and again, it is a sativa. You can't find that real Girl Scout cookie anymore. Or, for example, that White Widow that was back
in
the day.
White Widow.
Or that.
Telling your age.
I mean, telling my age, right? You know, I'm just saying, there's so many strains that are out there. I mean, it's amazing how many strains of marijuana you can try, and it'll do so many different things for you.
It's gotten to be where it's just like wine or anything acquired fine, cigars or anything. We're importing them. We're taking the time and the science to crossbreed. The genetics are involved. So you guys just think we're licking a seed and throw it in the dirt.
Nope,
things have changed.
Nope. There's different levels to the game, too, because remember, ladies and gentlemen, you got that top shelf, that private reserve, you got that exotic, and then you still got that dirt weed, you know? So there's things that are still out there, you know, and a real weed connoisseur would, as you would say, a wine connoisseur, now you are a weed connoisseur. You are looking for the greatest and the best, and, you know, that's what everybody wants to put into their body, just like your fine wines, except this doesn't have effects that will ruin your liver or give you a DUI or any of those things, you know?
No one's dying off of this stuff.
Not, you know, again, bigs up to Green Care Solutions and every one of us on the show. Big up to Trippy, Canada Businessman, Green Care Solutions for allowing us to be here on Green Talk, educating you guys in every way, shape, or form, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, we appreciate you guys tuning in to Green Talk. We are the Green Talk by Green Care Solutions on KCAA NBC Radio, and you can listen to us on iHeart Radio. We want to thank Green Care Solutions and all of their charity work. They've been really busy downtown LA feeding the homeless. They've now been doing the toy drive that starts in December. Make sure you look out for that. You can find Green Care Solutions and the Cannabis Businessman at the Elks Lodge to make your charities available with us at the Elks Lodge. Weeds Days at the Elks Lodge in San Bernardino.
You can also catch Green Care Solutions at San Bern Sesh on Saturday. Again, big up to Green Care Solutions. Follow them on Instagram at Green Care Solutions 420. Make sure you contact them at 951-609-4071. Big ups again to Green Care Solutions.
We're filming this at the Compound Production House in Burbank. We want to thank the Compound Production House and our special guest with our host. I'm Miko, the Cannabis Businessman. Bless up, sesh up with us.
Thanks for listening, guys. It's Trippy Trees.
And Mr. Hello, Mr. Conovation in the house. And big ups to Tia and Brian. We appreciate you guys being here. Green Care Solutions.
It was an honor, guys. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having us, guys. It was a pleasure.
You guys keep winning those awards. Keep representing the community and our industry so well. And everybody out there, have a happy Thanksgiving.
We did a lot of green talk.
Catch us next week, Thursday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 102.3, and you can also catch us on iTunes, Twitch, and other stations.
Yes, sir.
Make sure you tune in on KCAA NBC radio stations and affiliates, and enjoy your evening. Good night. Let me see your shoulders work.